白か黒しかこの世にはないと思っていたよ。
We know about Bob's never-ending tour. It's been going on for years. I guess it was around the end of the 20th century, really. Somewhere around there, he was touring and he would watch movies. He was an inveterate movie watcher. He had a TV on the tour bus with a VCR slot in it. And so when this comedy idea came along, he called me up. And my thought was, this is so cool. I'm gonna have one meeting with Bob and I'm gonna be able to brag to all my friends. All my friends are Dylan freaks. They would love to be in this position. I'm gonna actually meet Bob, I'm gonna talk to Bob, but I figured that would be it. But when I got there to meet him, we just sort of immediately got into conversation and started talking about the project. I was wearing pajamas, and I wore pajamas all the time. I don't know why, I was kind of starting to, maybe I was starting to break myself mentally. And he showed up to the meeting in full Western villain regalia, black hat, black duster, black boots, black gloves, black shirt, studded black shirt. He had the whole regalia. We sat in the coffee house and the first thing his assistant says, you guys want something to drink? And I said, yeah, I'll have like an iced coffee. And he said, I want something hot. I want a hot beverage. When they brought the hot beverage and the iced coffee, he immediately grabbed my coffee and started drinking the iced coffee. And so now I'm like in a Curb Seinfeld situation here. But you know, I'm meeting Bob Dylan for the first time. We've given our order and now he's stolen my drink. Now, do I say something and blow the whole thing or they just let it slide, you know? About halfway through, he goes, why aren't you drinking your drink? And I said, because you stole it. You stole my drink. You're drinking my drink. And he cracked up. And that kind of broke the ice to a large degree. The project was him basically as a kind of a Buster Keaton cipher type of character. Very stone-faced, very detached, walking through this surreal comic landscape, essentially, and using reference points from songs. That remained, that idea, that motif, was folded into what became the movie. We went back in and we started writing what became the Mastodon Anonymous script, folding some of these things into it.